Hey guys, welcome to this tutorial on how to dual boot your computer with Ubuntu 10.04 with your Windows 7 or Windows Vista operating system, plus Windows XP, but this will not work with the Mac. But first, what is Ubuntu? Watch this video right now. Well, as you just saw that video, that's Ubuntu. You can have special effects, everything is free in it, and it's completely fast. But I suggest not making it your full operating system. I say keep your Windows operating system and dual boot it. So if I were you, dual boot your computer with Ubuntu. By the way, when you do this, you will not lose any data. So if you want to get Ubuntu, make sure your computer meets the requirements of a 256 megabyte graphics card, maybe an integrated graphics card from Windows, and at least 1 gigabyte of RAM. So yeah, and make sure to know what bit your computer is. If you don't know what a bit is for your computer, basically it's from a 32-bit to a 64-bit, which can 64-bit can hold more RAM than a 32-bit. So to know what bit your computer is, or I'll show that now, first go to www.ubuntu.com. Once you're here, just click on Download Ubuntu, or you can open up, take the Ubuntu tour, and then once you're at this site, just scroll down and you can watch whatever it shows here that you can do on it. And it's pretty much easy. And Ubuntu similar to the Mac, but it's free. So once you're here, just click on Download Ubuntu. And then once you're at this page, you should notice where it says Begin Download. But first, before you do that, click where this arrow is pointing right here. And it'll show 32-bit or 64-bit version. So go to your start button if you're on Windows 7 or Windows Vista. Right-click on Computer. Click on Properties. Once you click on Properties, where it says System up here, and it says System Type, if it's a 64-bit operating system, get the 64-bit down here. If you have the 32-bit, get the 32-bit, vice versa. And once you click on 64-bit version, do not click here, because the reason is it'll take too long and the download speed's too slow. So if I were you, click on BitTorrent, which is right here. And then it'll bring you here. And it'll show Ubuntu 10.04 LTS. Choose this one, and if you have a 32-bit, click this one. But if you have a 64-bit, get the AMD 64. Click on that. You'll get an icon, a window like this. Save it to your desktop and click on Save. You should see a uTorrent icon. Just double-click here on the uTorrent. Make sure you get uTorrent at uTorrent.com, which is showing up right now. Go to that site in order to install uTorrent. So after you open up the uTorrent file, just save it to your desktop and click OK and wait for it to be done downloading. So after you downloaded Ubuntu 10.04 ISO image, you should see it on your desktop that shows this, except it shows a different icon or of a DVD or a WinZip icon. So once you see that there, now the problem is you guys think you have to use a CD in order to burn it. Well, I have an idea. Instead of using a CD, I have this program called Damien Tools. So if you want to mount this ISO image, just click on this link popping up now, watch that video, install the program, so you can mount this. So once you get Damien Tools Lite, after you watch that video, click down here where it says Show Hidden Icons, and then you'll see a Damien Tools icon that's a lightning. Right click on that, click on Virtual Devices, Device 0, Mount Image, click on your desktop up here, and open up the ISO image of Ubuntu 10.04. Double click on it, it says Mounting Image. And then after that, it should pop up in a few seconds, so I'll pause the video. Once it's done loading from the ISO image, by the way, Damien Tools makes a virtual drive. That means it pretends you have a CD drive, but you don't, so you can mount an ISO image, which is pretty cool. So once this window pops up, you'll notice three operations here. Click the middle where it says Install Inside Windows. Once you click on that, choose your installation drive. I suggest going to your C drive, because nothing's going to happen, so I suggest making it on your C drive. I'm going to choose my D drive. Make the installation size at least 10 gigabytes, or you can put it to the less, which is 3 gigabytes. So once you choose that, make up your username and make up your password. And leave the desktop environment to Ubuntu and click on install. This thing should be really done in like about 30 seconds, so I'll be back once it's done doing its thing. So after the installation is done, you should get a choice of I want to manually reboot later. Click reboot now, but before you reboot right now, I'm going to click this first. When you reboot, you'll get a choice between your operating system. Mine's Windows 7, but I'm looking at a picture here. Choose Ubuntu, which is below the operating system. After you choose Ubuntu, it should give a loadout menu. Just wait for that. And it say installation, just wait for the countdown. After that's done, you should get a window like this, and it says welcome, and it's going to be installing 10.04. Let it install, and if it says downloading language packs, you can go ahead and skip that, but I suggest just let it do its thing. After that's done, boot in Ubuntu, and I'll show you Ubuntu right now.